In this interactive simulation, we're looking at material and energy balances in a reactor that has heat exchange, and the only thing we're interested in is the balances. So we're not interested in kinetics, how the reaction actually takes place. What we want to look at is, and we have a choice, we can either select the outlet temperature and then observe the behavior, how much conversion we have. For example, we run it adiabatically, where there's no heat removed. Or we can select the extent of reaction, and that determines what the outlet temperature is going to be if it's adiabatic. Now, we can remove heat by moving this slider. It's going to lower that outlet temperature, and depending on what we're controlling, we're going to have then the same extent of reaction. If we, however, select the outlet temperature and then remove heat, we'll increase the extent of reaction. So we can change the ratio of A to B by the inlet number of moles of B. We can also add inert to the system, and that's going to affect the final temperature, and therefore it's going to affect what conversion we're going to end up with. And so what we've done is solve mass and energy balances to give a better feeling for the behavior of the system. So we'll look at the interactive simulation. We'll see what happens as we change these variables. This interactive simulation is strictly looking at mass balances and energy balances. So it's not considering kinetics or equilibrium of reactions. And the idea is that if we specify the outlet temperature, then it calculates the conversion that would correspond to that outlet temperature. So we're looking at an exothermic reaction, and the temperature increases. If I go to a higher temperature, I can get more conversion. If I remove heat, so this is the amount of heat removal, and so heat is negative, meaning energy is being removed from the system, then the conversion increases because I've constrained this temperature. Removing heat means I had more reaction, but much of the heat of reaction was removed in heat transfer, so the final temperature of heating up reactants and products at 293. The combination of that heating plus the heat removal determines how much reaction we've had. If instead I use extent of reaction as my variable, so I can change the extent of reaction. Now we're looking at conversion, gives us the temperature, and if I go to high enough extent of reaction, the temperature's too high, saying above 1,000 degrees is not realistic for this system, and so if I wanted to get that high an extent of reaction, I'd have to remove heat from the system. And so all we're doing here is just doing mass and energy balances to help us understand the behavior of a reactor.